A significant advantage of using Google Sheets or Excel for calculations is the ability to automate repetitive tasks, like copying and reusing formulas. Let's go back to our vacation expense tracker. Now we have two trips that we're keeping track of, one for a trip to Dallas, Texas, and another one to New York City. We want to set up formulas for our trip to Dallas and copy them over to the New York City one. There are several ways we can do that. The first way of copying formulas is simply by copying and pasting them. First, I'm going to perform cost calculation for our two tickets to Dallas by entering equal, then selecting cell D5 for number of tickets and E5 for cost per ticket to find out it costs us $1,200 for our air travel. In Google Sheets, you can copy the formula from cell F5 by pressing Command plus C on Mac or Control plus C on PC, or go to Edit, Copy. Then go to cell F6 for total lodging expenses and press Command V on Mac or Control V on PC. I will continue to do the same for the rest of the expenses. Before we move to the second way of copying formulas, I will perform two more calculations that I will use later on. To calculate the total expenses, I will use the sum function and add up all the costs together. I also need to calculate the cost per day for our trip, so I will take the total expenses and divide it by 5, which is the total days that I spent in Dallas. Now, the second way of copying a formula is by using the fill option. I'm going to go to my New York City trip and create the formula for the total cost for our tickets to the Big Apple. Then instead of using the copy and paste method, I will hover over the lower right corner of my cell until I see a blue fill handle. I will click, hold, and drag the fill handle over the cells to which I want to copy the formula. Once I'm done, I will release the mouse or trackpad. We are going to quickly check the formulas by double clicking on the cells to see which cells are included in it. The cell references should be different for each cell, depending on its row, and they are. To calculate the total expenses and cost per day, I will use the copy and paste option because it is more logical to use here. However, when I double check my formulas, I notice that the cost per day formula is not correct for New York City, as that trip was 4 days long, not 5 days like the Dallas trip. This is why using manual numbers in formulas can cause problems and should be avoided. To fix this, I will go back to my cost per day calculation for Dallas and create a formula that references different total trip days for each trip. Now when I paste over the formula from the Dallas trip to New York, it works perfectly because it references number of days, which is different for each trip. The next two ways of pasting formulas are with autofills. This feature allows you to quickly fill down a formula or a series of values in adjacent cells. First, we need to enter the formula in the cell where we want to start the sequence. Then we need to move our cursor to the small square located in the lower right corner of the cell. Now we double click that square. Google Sheets automatically copied the formula down as far as there's data in the adjacent cells in the column to the left or right. This is a super quick way of pasting formulas, especially if you have many rows of data. The second way of using autofill is by selecting special suggestions autofill option in Google Sheets. Let me show you how that works. After I enter the formula in the first total cost cell and press enter, I get a message that shows me suggested autofill formula. I can press the check mark if I agree with the suggestion or press command enter. I can also decline the suggestion by selecting the X. As you can notice, this doesn't always work 100% as the formula copied over down to our total expenses and cost per day, which requires different formulas, but we can just delete them. Now, in order for the suggested autofill option to work in your spreadsheet, you have to activate it by going to Tools, Autocomplete, and making sure you have the Enable Autocomplete option checked. Finally, the last way of copying formulas is with the Paste Special option. If I copy my formulas from the Dallas trip to my New York City, you can see that my formatting changed also. So instead of using the Command V option, we will go to Edit, Paste Special, and select Formulas Only to keep our New York City formatting. Now, one main point about all these copying and pasting options here is that we used relative cell references, which are the default cell references in Google Sheets and Excel. What it means that when you copy over formulas, the cells referenced in it change in relation to the new relative position of rows and columns. However, there are many times you may want to keep the references absolute and not change when copied. In that case, you could opt to have the row and or column constant. These are called absolute references. We will go over the main differences later in the course. Thanks so much for watching.